Hi, I'm Carl Taylor, and this episode is sponsored by Squarespace. Here's my commercial photography website. It's a Squarespace one, and I absolutely love it. They're easy to set up, they look amazing, there are hundreds of templates to choose from, and they have first-class customer support. If you want one too, then use this URL and the coupon code CARL to get a 10% discount. Hi, I'm Carl Taylor. Now, many of you have asked questions about stuff that we've purchased for our studio fit out in our new studio here. And one of the first things I want to review for you is this amazing projector that I bought. This is the Canon ZEED XEED 6000. It was an expensive purchase. What did it cost? It was about £4,000, but we needed this for our training courses to project big images onto the wall for Photoshop training, so students on workshops could follow along, or if we're creating a video, that we could have this as a background image on the wall. Now, I'm really impressed with this because I was looking for a projector that had a long throw. Our problem was that our studio here is very big. We've got this 12 meter range from here to here, and the projector sits up on that platform that we had constructed. I'll show you that in a minute when we show you the projector linked up. And we project the image onto this wall. And this is a really long distance, 12 meters. Now, the problem and the mistake that I made is when I bought this projector, it came with the standard lens. And when we projected our image onto the wall with the standard lens, it was too big, because the standard lens is meant for a closer use. So I then had to go and buy another lens, which is called the long throw projector lens, which basically is like a telephoto lens, zooms in and it creates a smaller picture. Now you can still zoom the picture in and out, and I'm gonna show you that in a minute when we link this projector back up. But I'm not a really knowledgeable audio-visual guy in this respect, but let me run through what I do know about it. You've got your power, your standby buttons, your menu and everything, but it's all controlled from the remote control, okay? So when the projector's up there, you can do all of this from the remote control. The main things are that you've got your standard VGA or whatever, your DVI type imports for your computer to go in. You've also got HDMI, which is obviously important. You've got an Ethernet cable connector there as well. You've got audio in and out and all the usual stuff, power and all the rest of it. Changing the lens over was very easy. Take the top off, unscrew it, lock it in, fit it in. That was the lens done, so it was all straightforward. And setting the whole thing up actually was a piece of cake. And the menu system on the remote control was very easy as well. Now, none of that is of any use to you whatsoever. All you really want to see is what it looks like when it's projecting an image, because that's all I was interested in as well. So let's get the thing rigged up. Oh, I'll tell you what also, the other day I had my 5-year-old daughter and some of her friends, they came around and watched a Blu-ray film, and it looked spectacular on that wall. It was like being at the cinema, because this is a 1920 by 1200 resolution. So it's actually higher resolution than a HD film, and the film looked superb. So it was great even for watching movies on. But let's set it up. Let's show you what it looks like. Okay, so we had this platform constructed. Adrian made this wonderful tray platform, bolted it onto the girder there. That holds our projector nice and steady. Then we've got some cables, power cable, nice and easy, boom, in it goes. HDMI cable, in it goes. And really that's all we use, because we're using the HDMI. There is the VGA one there, but I haven't bothered linking up the DVI because we're doing everything with just the HDMI, and that's it. And then I've got a Blu-ray player there, and I can then just take the HDMI from the Blu-ray player and swap it over with that one and link it in there as well. So yeah, that's it. Let's take a look at it in use. So we've turned the lights off. That's the image projected on the wall straight out of the computer. Let me just show you how amazing the detail is on this. I was really impressed with this. I mean, look at that. Just fantastic if we're doing Photoshop tutorials. So if we're doing Photoshop tutorials in our workshops, we can get this super huge image that the whole class can follow along on. Now, let's look at the zoom function. I'm gonna click zoom, and I'll show you, I can make this picture smaller, much, much smaller, here we go, which makes the picture brighter as well by going smaller. And I can make the picture much, much bigger as well. Let's keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. So you can see I can make this huge picture if I need to. And with the picture that big, I've got a picture from all the way over here, all the way over here. Huge picture, huge height, fantastic for watching movies or doing demonstrations or you know, playing video clips to our audience, to our students, and still a fantastic image quality. Let me just zoom back out a little bit. So zoom function, bring that back down. Now this other feature I really liked, I didn't know projectors could do this because I don't know a great deal about them, but lens shift. You can shift the picture quite dramatically up and down. So there you go, it's going up, 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 up. It's gonna actually go over the edge of our cove and off the top there. And it doesn't lose its parallel, so the image still stays perfectly parallel, which is fantastic. So if you need to shift the image up and down or get it lower to the ground for whatever reason, and you can also shift it left and right as well. So I can shift it more to the left. There we go, so it's going to the left. So it's fantastic that you can actually move the image around without any distortion whatsoever. Now, the projector's also got the typical keystone adjustments so that if the angle of your projector is not the same as your screen, then you can adjust those parallels. Now, the other thing that's interesting here is that this is not really a projector screen. This is just a white wall and we're getting that quality of image off there. I don't know what you're meant to project this stuff onto, but I'm really happy with the color that we're getting on the projector and the image that we're getting compared to what I'm seeing on my actual computer, because they're matching up really well. Now, I understand that you can actually calibrate these projectors specifically if you want to fine tune the colors and everything else on them. There are some basic settings on the image where you can change. I'm in dynamic at the moment. That's video, you've got cinema, you've got photo, sRGB, and standard. At the moment, I'm using it on dynamic because it seems to match more what I'm seeing on my computer screen, which I just prefer. Now, let's have a look with a bit of video as well. Let me just find a video clip. Let me just get rid of this and bring up something on a bit of video. I've got a video clip here, just a little MP4. And there's that hawk in the studio that we shot. And just after this, we've got a nice bit of footage that we did some slow motion footage. Let me just put this full screen. And you can see this lovely slow motion footage of the surfers that we filmed. And this projector is fantastic for showing video clips. As I said, I got my daughter and her friends came to watch a film the other day, and it was just like being at the cinema for them. So really, really pleased with the video playback quality on the projector as well. That's some stuff we filmed in Iceland for Fashionscape. So all in all, very pleased with the projector. I say it's not cheap. Do be careful that if you buy one of these projectors that you get the right lens, because the lens that I got that came with it, the standard lens, was too wide and too big for this 12 meter distance. So we had to get the long throw projector lens. They do an ultra wide angle lens if your projector's close to your screen or close to your wall. I think they do a back throw projector for illuminating through the transparent type screens as well. So just be careful to check out the specifications on the lens that you might need to suit your purposes. Anyway, hope you found that information useful.